afternoon, everyone, and a very warm welcome to this incredible location and venue of Elixir Ibiza for the wedding ceremony of Mark Turner and Emma Timpson.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dean, best man. What an honour it is to have this. I was shocked and surprised that I got asked, but honestly, I'm so delighted to be here. And I think everybody else is so thankful that we're here for this amazing, amazing place. I've never seen anything like this in my life. You've done so well with it.
I'd like to begin today by saying a huge thank you to all of you for being here with them. It's an absolute dream come true. They really are grateful to have you all here today because you're their people, their community, the ones that they love and admire the most. And they've brought you here to Ibiza because they love the island and couldn't think of a better venue than this one for the intimate wedding that they've always dreamed of. Emma and Mark have grown up together from teenagers over the last 10 years. From Mark being in the army, to training for and competing in triathlons, to doing his course and setting up his own business, then to Emma going through university and law school, they've always been there for each other. It can't have been easy to be apart while they each trained and studied, but they always made it work. They both adore their families, and we'll do anything for them.
It's gonna be alright tonight, oh my. It's gonna be alright, oh yeah. Come baby, the sun is gonna keep on shining. Brighter days on the horizon, my love for you will always keep on rising.
I met Marco through triathlon, and I've been chasing him ever since. I've got to say that the boy is a hell of an athlete, and every time I've raced with him, he's beating me. I take my hat off to you, you're an absolute superstar with it, mate.
It's gonna keep on rising.
Emma's my baby sister. Growing up, she borrowed everything I had. My toys, my sweets, and then onto my makeup and hair straighteners. She was the messiest teenager I've ever known. But she's the first to give up her bed when I was visiting home from uni or London. She will literally do anything for anyone. She's one of the most selfless people I know, a huge support to our family, and I'm proud to be her big sister and her bridesmaid today.
Come baby. The sun is gonna keep on shining.
Mark's like an extra little brother. Matching Emma's ethos, he too would do anything for you. And I'm absolutely delighted I can officially call him my brother-in-law. He's amazing with our children. Uncle Mark never lets them down. They bring out the best in each other and deserve every single day to be a happy one for the rest of their lives. I'm over the moon for you guys and crying writing this.
Look at the stars, look how they shine for you, and everything you do, and they were all you. I came alone, I wrote a song for you. Oh, what a thing to do. And it was called yellow. Oh. So then I took my time.
you guys, you don't know this, but to me, you guys are an absolute inspiration. You've done so much in your lives, the pair of you. I'm so proud to know you two, to see the journey that you're on. You've both been brave with your decisions. You, Marco, you're a master of your art with your work. You're an absolute class act with what you do.
I just want to say thanks for coming, really appreciate it. I'm not allowed to say how amazing Emma is today because she said I'm not allowed, so we all know who she is.
And Emma, what can I say? She's a gem, absolute gem, she really is. Love her to bits, you know.
Talk, let's have conversations in the dark.
Honestly, she's an absolute gem, she'd do anything for you, all the time. Little brat, when you were about 13, 14, I want to be a mosher, I want to get my ears pierced, I want to get my nose pierced, my belly pierced, and all the rest of it. But yeah, no, honestly, then after that, it's turned out absolute gem, didn't you? The screen is true. I've got my eyes on you. And you say that you're not worthy. You get hung up on your flaws. But in my eyes, you are perfect as you are. I will never try to change you. I will always want the same you. Swear on everything I pray to, that I won't break your heart. I'll be there when you get lonely. Keep the secrets that you told me. And your love is all you owe me. And so I'd like to say, wish them all the best together. Good luck for you in the future. No more kids just yet, though. You've got two kids, Reckitt and Teddy.
Wreck-It Ralph and Teddy. So yeah, I'd like you to all raise your glasses and wish them all the best. Don't mind, thank you very much.
Yeah.
And we got places we both gotta be. But there ain't nothing I would rather do. Than look for my plans for you. And you say that you're not worthy and get hung up on your flaws. But in my eyes, you are perfect as you are, as you are. I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want the same you, same you. Swear on everything I pray to that I.
Things I hate about myself that no one knows, but with you I see hope again. Oh, I'm a mess when I overthink the little things in my head. You seem to always help me catch my breath, but then I lose it again. When I get you, that's the end. And why do I get so nervous when I look into your eyes? Butterflies can't stop me falling for you. And darling, this is more than anything I felt before. You're everything that I want, but I didn't think I'd find someone who was worth the wait of all the years of my heartbreak. But I know now I've found the one I love. And I love the way you can never find the right things to say. And you can't sit still an hour in the day. I'm so in love, let's run away. Because us is enough. And why do I get so nervous when I look into your eyes?
What do you think, Emma, as your favourite person? Laugh with her, be an equal and loving partner, support her through life's tough moments, be proud of her, celebrate her achievements, grow old with her, and find new reasons to love her every day.
I do.
Mark Turner, do you take Emma Timpson to be your wife and best friend for life?
I do.
Emma, please slide us. Celebrate his achievements, grow old with him, and find new reasons to love him every day.
I will.
Do you, Emma Timpson, take Mark Turner to be your husband and best friend till the end?
I do.
Mark, please slide Emma's ring on. Mark and Emma, I'm very excited to announce that you are now husband and wife. You may kiss.
Thank you.
About your marriage being a continuation of your relationship and your love for each other, and about making it exactly what you want it to be. Your friends will know how important they are to you, as do your family. You've exchanged your vows, put rings on each other's fingers, and kissed. So falling for you. It took us a while, with every breath a new day. That means there's only one thing left to do, and that's to kick off your wedding day celebrations. Everybody please stand and get those petals ready. Introducing to you all the happy couple, Mr. and Mrs. Turner.
Still falling for you. Brighter than gold, this love shining brighter than gold. This love is like letters and bolts. This love is like out of control. This love's never growing old. You make it new. So falling for you. So falling for you. It took us a while, 'cause we were young and unsure. Love on the line. What if we both would need more? But all your flaws and scars are mine. So falling for you. So falling for you. So falling for you. And just like that, all I breathe, all I feel, you are all for me. I'm in. And just like that, all I breathe, all. Still falling for you. Falling, crashing to my arms. Love you like this, like a first kiss, never let go. Falling, crashing to my arms. Never breaking what we got. Falling for you. Still falling for. And just like that.
I don't think I've ever met a couple more compatible. You two are so well suited. I don't think anybody knows you other than Marco and Emma, the two of you together. And I think you're so good together. And I think that's really special, that bond that you've got. Really special. I was scared of pretty girls and starting conversations. All my friends are turning green. You're the magician's assistant in their dream. Oh,
been living on the high shelf. Oh, she's destined for the screen. Closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I wanna be your left hand man. I love you when you sing me that song. And I got a lump in my throat, cause you gonna sing the words wrong. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I wanna be your left hand man. I love you when you sing me that song.
I'm going to say is a bit of advice, and I got told this on my wedding day: never ever end a day on an argument. Never go to bed. Sort it out, get it done. You're married, and that's it. You're all good. So, everybody, can I ask for another toast to your bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Turner?
Just for me, but bear this in mind, it was meant to be. And I'm joining up the dots with the freckles on your cheeks, and it all makes sense to me. I know you've never loved the crinkles by your eyes when you smile. You've never loved your stomach or your thighs, the dimples in your back at the bottom of your spine, but I love them endlessly. I won't let these little things slip out of my mouth, but if I do, it's you, oh it's you, they add up to, I'm in love with you. And all these little things.
You can't go to bed without a cup of tea, and maybe that's the reason that you talk in your sleep. And all those conversations are the secrets that I keep, though it makes no sense to me.
There you go.
Not anyone. Forever's not enough time to love you the way that I want. 'Cause every morning I find you, I fear the day that I don't. You say that I won't lose you, but you can't predict the future, 'cause certain things are out of our control. Yeah, if you ever move on without me, I need to make sure you know.
I'm obsessed with the way your head is laying on my chest. How you love the things I hate about myself that no one knows. But with you, I see hope again. Oh, I'm a mess when I overthink the little things in my head. You seem to always help me catch my breath, but then I lose it again. When I look at you, that's the end. And why do I get so nervous when I look into your eyes? Butterflies can't stop me falling for you. And
darling, this is more than anything I felt before. You're everything that I want, but I didn't think I'd find someone who was worth the wait of all the years of my heartbreak. But I know now I've found the one I love. And I love the way you can never find the right things to say. And you can't sit still an hour in the day. I'm so in love, let's run away. Because us is enough.
Good afternoon, everyone. And a very warm welcome to this incredible location and venue of Elixir Ibiza for the wedding ceremony of Mark Turner and Emma Timpson. My name's Carly, and I'm the celebrant who's been given the honour of uniting these two here on Ibiza today. They'd like to start by thanking their flower girls, page boy, groomsmen, best man and bridesmaids for their support today and every day, and also for paving the way for Emma and Graham so beautifully. I think everyone will agree that you all made a stunning entrance, especially our beautiful bride with her proud dad. Today's ceremony has been created with input from Emma and Mark, and from some of you, to be a celebration of their relationship and of the next amazing stage of their lives together. It isn't focused around traditions or paperwork. It's about the two of them. It's about real life and real love, their family and their friends, and what marriage means to them as a couple. They'd like to begin today by saying a huge thank you to all of you for being here with them. It's an absolute dream come true. They might swap a couple of you for Freddie and Ralph if they could, though. Joking aside, they really are grateful to have you all here today, because you're their people, their community, the ones that they love and admire the most. And they've brought you here to Ibiza because they love the island and couldn't think of a better venue than this one for the intimate wedding that they've always dreamed of. Unfortunately, there are some very special people who've passed, and we'd like to take a moment to remember them before we move on today. Emma's grandparents, Mary and Jimmy Butler, and Joan and Paddy Timpson, Mark's grandparents, Stan Stamper, and June and James Turner, and his Uncle Paul, would all have been really proud and happy to be here. Though they aren't physically with us, the love for them, the memories with them, and the influence that they had on all of you will always remain. They're carried in everyone's hearts and minds today and every day. We're also missing a few people who haven't been able to travel, but I'm sure they're thinking of you back home as they wait for the photos to start flooding in. So before we start today, let's share a round of applause to celebrate the legacy and memory of those who've passed, and send some positive Ibiza sunshine to those who haven't been able to travel. The beauty of this place and the sounds of nature remind us all of how important it is to disconnect from technology from time to time and really connect with each other. So look around you and let it all sink in. Look at the views, the people, this beautiful sky, and think about how wonderful it is to be here to celebrate Mark and Emma today. Most importantly, look at these two up here in front of you all, ready to make promises to one another for their future together, and celebrate in style with you lovely people. This ceremony, which you're all going to be part of, will hopefully be a bit different to those you've experienced before. It won't be a normal, formal wedding, so please feel free to laugh, to cry, to clap, to cheer, and to fully immerse yourselves in the ceremony and, of course, the celebrations after. Now, to start the ceremony with a very personal touch, I have a few words to share from Charlotte, who hasn't been able to make it, as she's due a baby any day now, right? Emma and Mark have grown up together from teenagers over the last 10 years. Gone are the days of crazy nights out, festivals and concerts. They're definitely more homebirds now. They love being there with their dogs, Freddie and Ralph. One thing they definitely don't have in common is their taste in food. Mark has always loved fresh food and will try something different on the menu every time. Emma, on the other hand, loves a cheeky Mackie's, but wouldn't touch a vegetable if her life depended on it. They've always supported each other in everything the other has wanted to do, from Mark being in the army, to training for and competing in triathlons, to doing his course and setting up his own business, then to Emma going through university and law school. They've always been there for each other. It can't have been easy to be apart while they each trained and studied, but they always made it work. They both adore their families and will do anything for them. They're also an amazing auntie and uncle who are so thoughtful and caring for their nieces and nephew. Mark will always come and do some work in your house, no matter how long of a day he's had. And Emma is so thoughtful, always remembering the little things and being ready to congratulate you with homemade cake or cookies. They're definitely best friends. They never get bored of each other or being in each other's company. And I would say they're soulmates. They just know each other so well, and we're so sad we can't be there today. So thank you, Charlotte. We're here today because of love. The ability to love is the best thing about being human. It can unite us, drive us, give us hope, and make us feel incredible. Everybody here today will have their own love stories, but the one we're going to focus on right now is of these two gorgeous people. Because before we start the next chapter, it's always fun to pass by a few highlights in the story so far. Emma and Mark have known each other since they were in secondary school. Mark had dated a few of Emma's friends. Despite him regularly asking Emma out and Emma rejecting him every time. Sarah remembers how Mark pursued Emma and tried his best to win her over, whilst she acted like she wasn't interested and pointed out everything he was doing wrong. His perseverance finally paid off though, when Emma was 17 and he was 19. And she agreed to go on a few dates. Those dates never went quite to plan, and a few years passed before Emma and Mark saw each other again at the Tanner pub on a Sunday sesh. This time, there were definitely sparks between them. They started dating in March 2012, and after a few months, Emma told Mark he needed to ask her to be his girlfriend. They officially began their relationship on the 10th of June, 2012. During this time, Mark was in the army and lived in Colchester in Essex. He would travel up to Skelmersdale every weekend so that they could see each other. And Emma visited Colchester on a few occasions too. In August 2012, they traveled to Milton Keynes Bowl for their first ever concert together, which was the Swedish House Mafia. Emma thought it would be a good idea to try and outdrink her brother whilst they were watching the support acts. This wasn't the greatest idea and resulted in Mark ending up helping her back to the tent and then sitting up listening to Swedish House Mafia in the distance. Now that's some serious dedication to your girlfriend. That same year, Emma had her first trip abroad when Mark surprised her with a visit to Paris for her 20th birthday. He left the army in 2013 and moved back to Skelmersdale and in with his mum. Since then, Emma and Mark have spent near enough every day together. Emma's parents would agree that Mark unofficially moved into theirs for about 80% of the time. In fact, Mark, they told me that they're pretty sure you still owe them rent. But as you've helped them out so much over the years, which they really appreciate, they'll call it quits. In April 2019, they got their first home together. And in July that year, Freddie arrived. Emma had missed out on a training contract at work, and Mark asked what he could do to cheer her up. She said, "Get me a puppy." So, always wanting to see her happy, he did. The following year, Ralph, their second rescue pup, joined the tribe. They've travelled extensively over the years, with highlights being Iceland in 2015 and again in 2017. Amazing, but risky fun as people let New Year's Eve fireworks off in the streets. And then Mexico in 2016, which was one of their best holidays yet, despite almost being eaten alive by bedbugs and flies. Mark, competing for Team GB in triathlons, has also seen them travelling far and wide. Here to Ibiza, to Canada, and to Australia's Gold Coast, to name but a few. And Emma is always by his side as he travels. She's his biggest fan. I'm told it's not unusual for her to drop an army roll under a fence just to catch a 10-second glimpse of him in action. I'm also told that Mark reciprocates this level of dedicated and unerring support for Emma's favourite pastime, napping. Jokes aside though, guys, everybody I spoke to about the two of you told me that you are such a connected and supportive couple who always have each other's backs. Dana told me that Finn and Pand are two peas in a pod who never stop talking. She remembers that Mark used to get home, having just spent days on end with you, Emma, and immediately start to message or FaceTime while he was having his tea. Something you apparently still do today, even though you live together. She and absolutely everybody else said that you're a selfless couple who would and do anything for anyone who needs you. You're the kindest, most thoughtful people, and always there for the family. Even if it means taking your sister Sarah along to triathlons, concerts, festivals, beach trips, or even inviting her to join you for a cuddle when she's a bit down. In fact, Sarah comes along on so many occasions that it's become a running joke that she's the third wheel in all the photos.
I'm the third wheel.
But Emma's the third wheel in the photos. She treasures the relationship the three of you have so much, and she wouldn't want her little sister and her best friend to be with anybody else. She's really happy that you found each other, because you're such a great couple, and it's so clear that you make each other very happy. She's excited for your future together, because she knows it's going to be a very happy one. Mary echoed those sentiments. She told me, "Emma's my baby sister. Growing up, she borrowed everything I had. My toys, my sweets, and then onto my makeup and hair straighteners. She was the messiest teenager I've ever known. But she's the first to give up her bed when I was visiting home from uni or London. She will literally do anything for anyone. She's one of the most selfless people I know, a huge support to our family, and I'm proud to be her big sister and her bridesmaid today. Mark's like an extra little brother. Matching Emma's ethos, he too would do anything for you. And I'm absolutely delighted I can officially call him my brother-in-law. He's amazing with our children. Uncle Mark never lets them down. They bring out the best in each other and deserve every single day to be a happy one for the rest of their lives. I'm over the moon for you guys and crying writing this." To the happy couple, love from the Bears. No. Stamps, apparently not Mum or Sue, told me that she has always liked and got on well with Emma and couldn't have picked a lovelier girl for her Mark. The fact that she can get away with telling you off is a bonus, Emma. She says you are really lovely together and she's so happy for you. Emma, your parents said you were a model child, a slightly bratty teen like most are, but that you soon settled down and realised how intelligent you were, passing all your exams without any real effort. You're the kindest, most thoughtful person anyone could wish to meet, and they're so proud to call you their daughter. They weren't sure about Mark at first, because no one's ever good enough for your baby girl, but he soon wormed his way in, didn't he? And as we've already heard, ended up living there most of the time. They think you two are an amazing couple, and they wish you every happiness. Everyone knew the two of you would be together forever, so it came as no surprise to anyone when on your 8-year anniversary, June the 10th, 2020, Mark proposed. Of course, Emma said yes. And that brings us to today. here on this gorgeous terrace as you begin life as the Turners. Emma and Mark, after 10 years of loving each other already, today you're here to make promises which will deepen and strengthen your sense of commitment to each other and honour how in love you are and how you intend to keep on loving each other. But how do you describe love? It's an action. It makes you want to travel to be with someone, follow them around as their number one fan, support them wholeheartedly in every aspect, and spend all your time together. Emma, you told me that you love Mark because he always supports you and encourages you to be the best version of yourself, even when you give him a hard time about telling me what to do. He never gets angry, is generally a calm person to be around, and he always makes time for people. Okay, so he can't be without the background noise, subconsciously slams doors and drawers, and he doesn't always fully listen. We won't bring up the marriage license. But nobody's perfect. All you know is that he makes you happy, and he is perfect for you. Mark, you said you love Emma because she's the most selfless person you've ever met. She puts everyone before herself. She's so smiley and happy that she brightens up the room. And she's absolutely beautiful. She might be messy, constantly want to redecorate, and always want tickles and massages. But those little imperfections make her the person that she is, your person. You've seen each other through the best and worst of times, celebrating together and supporting each other. You've loved each other through good moods and bad moods, first thing in the morning when you're a bit worse for wear, and when you're looking sensational, like you do right now. You've built trust, respect, and appreciation for each other, and made a fantastic home and life together. And now, you're here to tell each other that you plan to stick around, that you want to carry on sharing your life with each other, all of the beautiful, happy, and content moments, as well as any more difficult ones. You're promising today that you are and always will be on each other's team, a shoulder to cry on and someone to jump for joy with, best friends as well as romantic partners. Marriage is a relationship unique to every couple who go into it, so there's no rule book to read you or advice I can list off, because you already know what to do to be happy together. All you need to do is carry on. Make marriage what you want it to be, and do it all in your own way. Live your life together with your joint vision pushing you forwards. The only thing I do think is worth saying is that sometimes you'll take each other for granted. That's life. But be conscious of it and try every day to do something that makes the other person smile and lets them know how much you love them. And if you ever do feel taken for granted, talk it out and fix it together. Mark and Emma, the time has finally come for the moment everyone's been waiting for. It's time to make your vows and exchange your rings. Can you please stand and face each other in the middle here? Yeah, we'll put you this side for the wind. The vows that you're about to make will lay the foundation of your marriage. From the moment you met to this moment right now, you've been so many things to one another. Your crush, date, boyfriend or girlfriend, housemate, travel buddy, co-parent, fiance, and absolute rock. And soon, you'll become something brand new as you can finally say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. Dee,
please could you bring the rings up?
Want me?
Emma and Mark, please take each other's ring from Dean.
Thanks very much.
Thank you, Dean. Mark and Emma, keep hold of those rings for just a minute. And as you do, think of the vows you're going to make and how excited you are that you're about to finally be called Mr. and Mrs. Turner. Warm the rings with your love for each other and all your dreams for the future. When you exchange them, you'll wear them as a sign to the world that you're loved
and you love another person with all your heart. It will also remind you that no matter where you are, what time of day or night it is, what you're doing or how you're feeling, you're connected and you always have each other. Emma, please take Mark's left hand and hold the ring at the tip of his finger. Mark, will you keep Emma as your favourite person? Laugh with her, be an equal and loving partner, support her through life's tough moments, be proud of her, celebrate her achievements, grow old with her, and find new reasons to love her every day.
I do.
Mark Turner, do you take Emma Timpson to be your wife and best friend for life?
I do.
Emma, please slide his ring on.
I'm in the heat.
Now, Mark, please hold Emma's ring at the tip of her finger. Emma, will you keep Mark as your favourite person? Laugh with him, be an equal and loving partner, support him through life's tough moments, be proud of him, celebrate his achievements, grow old with him, and find new reasons to love him every day.
I will.
Do you, Emma Timpson, take Mark Turner to be your husband and best friend till the end?
I do.
Mark, please slide Emma's ring on. Mark and Emma, I'm very excited to announce that you are now husband and wife. You may kiss. Emma and Mark, we've talked about your marriage being a continuation of your relationship and your love for each other, and about making it exactly what you want it to be. Your friends all know how important they are to you, as do your family. You've exchanged your vows, put rings on each other's fingers, and kissed. That means there's only one thing left to do, and that is to kick off your wedding day celebrations. Everybody, please stand and get those petals ready. Introducing to you all the happy couple, Mr. and Mrs. Turner.
Hi everyone, I just want to say thanks for coming, really appreciate it. I'm not allowed to say how amazing Emma is today because she said I'm not allowed, so we all know she is anyway. I did have a long speech, but Graham's going to take most of the time because he's quite boring, so. So yeah, that's it. I'll pass you over to Graham.
Right, I'll tell you what now, tell you right from the start, Emma and Mark, this has been planned for about 2 years, we're not having speeches. We're not having speeches, no speeches, it's cringe. So I haven't prepared a speech, but, and to be honest, the celebrant before, she said everything, didn't she? She said everything about these two. But I could tell you a few stories if you want to stick around for a minute like that. Well, first of all, before I do, I just want to thank you all for coming. It's a bit like a world, you know, event, isn't it? We've got like people from Dubai, Lanzarote, and was it?
Skem.
Oh, Skem. Well, that was a down, wasn't it? Where are you from? Alicante, is it? Yeah, Alicante, see? So everyone's flowing in for the occasion. But yeah, seriously, so I'd like to thank you all for coming. Thank all the staff here, the videographer and the photographers, everyone else. Big hand for them, please, to begin with. Oh, it's coming. Oh, it's coming, Mark. Oh, it's coming. And I'll just ask seriously, because Dean's got a massive speech, he said. He's been working on it. I don't know how many days he's been here now, and every day he's been at the pool working on his speech. So I'm going to have to leave a bit of time for Dean. But when I first met Mark, I was a little bit, you know, as you are with your daughter. No one's ever good enough for your daughter, so. But I got told he boxed, you see. So it was a little concern, you know. Anyway, on this day, finally, Emma said, can Mark come in? Yeah. And I'm like, yeah. So, yeah, go on, yeah. And then in walks this 4'2" lad, you know. And I'm kind of, phew, that's a relief, you know what I mean? So, and That was that. The first thing I thought about Mark was, seriously, like, you love this now, right? Who's even into One Direction? But who, especially bloke, would be into One Direction and admit it, you know? And, but Mark did, so I took my hat off and I thought, well, if you're brave enough to admit that, you know. And even now, he still asks me, have you listened to Harry Styles' new album yet? Listened to Harry Styles' new album yet? You know, life-changing, see what I mean? He's got problems, but anyway. And then the worst thing was, good enough, he used to, well, like you all know before, she told you, he kind of moved his way in, you know, and couldn't get rid of him for a couple of years or so. You did do us a couple of jobs though, didn't you? Hung a couple of rate eaters like that. You know, especially one at a time. But I believe he's good at his job now. No, I worked with Mark for a while and he is good at his job now, you know. He's learned.
You have to practice somewhere.
Yeah, I know, yeah. He's done a bit of work in yours, hasn't he? Because I remember when I was armed at yours and it was like that.
Yeah.
So having a look, yeah. So yeah, it's good. The thing was, as I say, he always used to make a brew, and one day I thought, you know what, I'll make them a brew when they come in. Do you want a brew now? Opens the cupboard, One Direction mug. One Direction mug. Oh shit. Sorry. One Direction mug. That's gonna be on the video. Spilling my thing on his dress. And that was it then. That was it. But no, seriously, I've took my hat off to Market Priest. Really good lad. And I worked with you for a while, didn't I? And then he come, I'm not sure if I should say this, but you did come round to show me your tool, didn't you? I mean, you did. Yeah, so he opens his side door and the van slides are open. He's like, look at this. And he gets this tool, and it's a suction thing for doing tiling, you see. He sticks to the tiles, makes the job easier for him. So he gets this tool out and he's like, look at this, Greg, look at this on the side of his van. You know, look at this. And then he kind of puts it away and half puts it away. And he's like, look how good it is and all this. Like. And what it was, I'd say, we'd known him for years anyway. I'd worked with him and everything. He said, I've been meaning to ask you something for a while. It's like, can I marry Emma? You know what I mean? I mean, so that was really, really nice. Really nice, that. Really nice. And Emma, you all know Emma.
Here I am.
This is Emma. No. What can I say? She's a gem. Absolute gem. She really is. Love her to bits, you know. She was right before. I mean, what was her name? The celebrant said before. She put everything in though, I was going to say. That's why I haven't got a speech anymore. But no, honestly, it's an absolute chance to do anything for you all the time. Little brat, when you were about 13, 14, I want to be a mosher. I want to get my ears pierced. I want to get my nose pierced, my belly pierced, and all the rest of it. But yeah, no, honestly, then after that, it's turned out absolute gem, didn't you? So I'd like to say, wish them all the best together. Good luck for you in the future. No more kids just yet, though. You've got two kids, Reckitt and Teddy. Reckitt, Ralph and Teddy. So, yeah, I'd like you to all raise your glasses and wish them all the best, if you don't mind. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
And then just one more thing. You wait there. No, it's not bad. It's not bad. Definitely should have got this out before. It's not bad, Mark. And basically, this, I'll show you my... No, don't start. Basically, to sum it up, stand up and open that up. It's not nothing much, just a little. This is... Game over. And Dean, you'd like to come in there?
It's taken up all my memory on my phone, this speech. Right, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dean, best man. What an honour it is to have this. I was shocked and surprised that I got asked, but honestly, I'm so delighted to be here. And I think everybody else is so thankful that we're here for this amazing, amazing place. I've never seen anything like this in my life. You've done so well with it. Right. Can I first just mention how amazing the new Mrs. Turner looks? Can we give her a little bit of love? And now it's time for Marco's deepest and darkest secrets to all come out. All of them.
Can't wait.
And he's sweating a bit now. First and foremost, the other groomsman, Bobby Ramsey over there. There he is. Hopefully everybody gets to meet Ramsay tonight. He's a great lad. And we've got Charlie as well. If he takes his top off, it's quite impressive, the colour that you've got under there, pal. He looks stunning. Nice and pink. Nice and pink. Right, now, Marco, there's nothing too bad in this speech. I met Marco through triathlon, and I've been chasing him ever since. I've got to say that the boy is a hell of an athlete, and every time I've raced with him, he's beating me. I take my hat off to you. You're an absolute superstar with it, mate. I think the first thing I want to do is I want to do a little bit of a test here. So can you all just raise one arm up? Just everybody, one arm, everybody. Right, belting, right, put them back down. Raise your hand if you've ever missed your own stag do. Put your hand up. Yeah. Yeah. In all my years and all the stag do's I've been on, maybe like 12 o'clock at night, the stag gets a little bit tired, goes to bed. This boy never turned up. We finished. You did a few hours. We finished him off on the first day. Second day, he was a no-show. But you did a good job. We expected it. We expected it. I think what I'm going to do is I want to play a little bit of a game with you two. And I want to be really cringy with it as well.
Great.
Right? So if your answer is going to be Marco, you're going to hold this up.
Okay.
Both of you.
Yeah.
And if your answer is Emma, we'll go for the classy wine glass.
Okay.
Right?
The beer for Mark.
He can go for his empty wine glass.
Okay.
Got to be classy. Right. Couple of questions. We're just going to make sure the calibration's right of you two first. Who's the fastest runner? We've got that. Who's the tallest?
Just.
Really?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Okay. Who's likely to vomit at the end of a night? Really? Well, these are surprising.
You'll see you later.
On the next day.
Who's most likely to get sunburnt? Yes. Every time I've seen it. Who moans the most? Oh. Controversial. Who's likely to want to decorate the house next?
When we get home.
And now we're going to get a little bit dark, a little bit romantic. Who's the best kisser? Well.
Ralph.
And who's the best lover?
We don't do that.
We don't do that?
We got married today. So.
Celibate, right, fine, we'll take that.
And any of you got married today?
Well, the next question is, who's most likely to say, no, Marco, not tonight?
Yep.
Exactly.
That'll be Teddy.
That'll be Teddy. Now, honestly, you guys, you don't know this, but to me, you guys are an absolute inspiration. You've done so much in your lives, the pair of you. I'm so proud to know you two, to see the journey that you're on. You know, you've both been brave with your decisions. You, Marco, you're a master of your art with your work. You're an absolute class act with what you do. I think there's nobody that I know that takes the attention to detail that you do with your work, and you should be proud of yourself. And I know all of your family and your friends are so proud of you, mate. And Emma, you've been so brave, faced a lot of adversity, a lot of tough decisions to make, but you know, he'll never ever lose money on a job ever again now because he's got you by his side.
Not with me in control.
But honestly, you know, I don't think I've ever met a couple more compatible. You two are so well suited. I don't think anybody knows you other than Marco and Emma, the two of you together. And I think you're so good together. And I think that's really special, that bond that you've got.
Thanks,
really special. Normally a best man speech is all about the darkest and deepest secrets, but I can't do that to you tonight. It wouldn't be fair. I think special mention to yourself for arranging this fantastic event that we've all been here for today.
Mark had loads to do with it.
No, I think a round of applause for Emma for what she's done. Well deserving. You've done amazing. Apparently we're going to a beach club tomorrow as well. That's what he's planned.
No, we're not.
There's a compromise then, okay. So the only thing I'm going to say is a bit of advice, and I got told this on my wedding day, never ever end a day on an argument. Never go to bed. Sort it out, get it done. You're married, and that's it. You're all good. So everybody, can I ask for another toast to your bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Turner? Come on, woo! Congratulations.
Thank you.